हेलो पीपल, वेलकम वन एंड ऑल टू जोजोस लर्निंग क्लब।
हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल जोजोस लर्निंग क्लब। सो टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन पार्ट टू कंप्लीटिंग द स्क्वायर। ऑन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑन हाउ टू फाइंड द रूट्स ऑफ अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन यूजिंग फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड। इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच दैट वीडियो प्लीज डू वॉच इट, देन इट वुड बी रियली हेल्पफुल फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर ऑन क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। एंड ऑन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी कवरिंग अपॉन हाउ टू फाइंड द रूट्स ऑफ अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन यूजिंग कंप्लीटिंग द स्क्वायर मेथड। Before that, I have a small reminder that this is my second upload. Actually, in my previous upload, I made a small mistake and my cousin Ajay, we call him Appu, he helped me find out the error. Thanks Appu for your support. Okay, so now let's directly start with the video. Before to start with the section on completing the square, let's understand what a perfect square is. What are the examples of a perfect square? So, x square. This is an example of a perfect square, which are completely divisible. So these are called perfect squares. So x plus 3, the whole square, any kind of these, kind like which you can completely find the roots. For example, for a perfect square, I have a number on the other side of the equation. Okay, now when you take the roots on both sides of the equation, what happens? You can readily find your answer plus or minus 3. So, the process of rearranging the quadratic equation in such a way that one side of the equation is a perfect square and the other side is only a number, then you can readily obtain your solution by just taking the square root on both sides. And this process of rearranging a quadratic equation into completing the square before solving the equation is called the completing the square method. And don't worry about anything, I will help you out understand with three problems. So with each problem you'll get a better understanding on how to find the roots of a quadratic equation using the completing the square method. Okay, on my first problem, there are several steps by steps which you follow to find the roots of a quadratic equation. Let me read all these steps. First step is that rearrange the quadratic equation so that all terms are on the same side of the equation. For example, if you have an equation such as x square plus 4x equal to 5, so how you can rearrange into one side of the equation, that is you take all the numbers and all the expression to one side of the equation. So this is what meant by the first step. And what is the next step? Make the coefficient of x square term unity. That is, in this it is already 1, but in these problems you can see that they are 2. So how to remove that coefficient from there? So you can just divide the entire section by 2, or for example by the number which is there as a coefficient. And the next step is that now rearrange the equation so that x square and x are on this one side of the equation. Then what we have to do, okay, I will do with this problem, then you will get a better understanding. This is already satisfied, right? Because here already the coefficient of x is 1 and it is unity. Okay, so first two steps are okay. Now rearrange the equation so that x square and x are on one side of the equation and constant is on the other side. So what are the x square and x terms? These are the x square and x terms, right? So I'm going to rearrange it. X square plus 3x is equal to minus 5. Am I doing right? Okay, the same as I'm going to follow each of these steps and find the roots using completing the square method. Okay, so the third step is also satisfied. Now what it is said? Add to both sides of the equation half the coefficient of x. So the next step is that, what is the coefficient of x here? Coefficient of x is 3. I have to take half of it and add to both sides of the equation. So 3x plus 3 by 2, the whole square, is equal to minus 5 plus 3 by 2, the whole square. Why am I doing so? I am doing so that this becomes a perfect square. What do I mean by perfect square? You can write like x plus 3 the whole square. Now what, just find what is x plus 3 by 2 the whole square. It is nothing but x square plus 2 into x into 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 the whole square. right? It is same as this equation. So we did all these steps so that our LHS becomes a perfect square and it is easy to find the answer. Okay, so this step is over and now I'm going to solve this. Minus 5 plus 3 square is 9 by 4. Okay, I have to solve for these fraction, then you have to substitute. Minus 5 plus 9 by 4, let me find out 1 into 4, and this is 4, right? So minus 20 plus 9 by 4, that is minus 11 by 4. So you can express x plus 3 by 2, the whole square is equal to minus 11 by 4, right? Okay, so you have minus 11 by 4. Now what you can do? You can deal with taking the square roots on both sides. That is, so that you can find the roots of the equation. That is, x plus 3 by 2 is equal to plus or minus root of minus 11 by 4. As there is a negative sign inside the root, it becomes a complex number. I'm not going to that sections for now. And in my later sections, I'll be covering up on how to deal when you have a negative or root of minus 1 is like a complex number. So I'm not going to deal with it for the time being. Just write the same as I'm writing here. Okay, so x is equal to minus 3 by 2 plus or minus root of minus 11 by 4. So what are the roots of these equation? One root is minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 minus 11 by 4, right? Or if you want, you can write this 4 outside, because comma minus 3 by 2 plus root of minus 11 by 4. So plus and minus, these are the two roots. Okay, and you can easily obtain the solution now, right? So it is very easy. I will just explain you once again. The first step is that make all the variables, all the expressions onto the one side of the equation. Okay, and what is the next step? You have to make the, if the x square coefficient is not unity, then you have to make the coefficient of x square as unity. But for our, we are lucky that our, the first problem, x square is already, coefficient is 1. So the second step is done. And what is the third step? Then you move the x square and x terms on one side of the equation and the constant on the other side of the equation. The last and final step is that you add half the coefficient of x, the whole square, to both sides of the equation. Okay, so it becomes x plus 3 by 2, the whole square. What happens over here? There's a minus 5 already here and 9 by 4. What is 9 by 4? That is minus 11 by 4, right? Then you can take roots on both sides. So what happens? If this becomes x plus 3 by 2, whenever you take a root of a square root, what, there are plus or minus. There are two answers possible, like here. X square is equal to 9, so there are two possible answers for it, plus or minus 3. Same way, plus or minus root of minus 11 by 4. This number is actually a complex number, but I'm not going to deal with complex numbers for now. Actually, you can write it as root of 11i, like this way, in terms of I, but I'm not going to discuss for the time being, and on my later sections I'll be covering up on entire module on complex numbers where you'll be dealing with all these kind of problems. Okay, so for the time being it's over, and now let's directly start with the second problem. What is the second problem saying? 2x square plus 5x minus 3. Okay, what is the first step to be said? All terms should be written on one side of the equation. It is okay, and what is the second step? Second step is that you have to make the x square term unity, but here it is 2. So what we have to do? You have to divide the entire equation by 2. So what happens here? It becomes x square, both sides, 0 by 2 is anyway 0. So x square plus 5 by 2x minus 3 by 2 is equal to 0. And what is the next step? Keep x square and x terms on one side of the equation and put the constant on the other side of the equation. What happens when a constant or any variable which moves from one side of the equation to the other side of the equation? There is a change of sign. So x square plus 5 by 2x is equal to 3 by 2. Right. What is the next step? You have to take half the coefficient of x. the whole square and add to both sides of the equation. So x square plus 5 by 2x plus 5 by 4 the whole square is equal to 3 by 2 plus 5 by 4 the whole square. Am I doing right? Why we are doing all these things? We are doing so that the LHS becomes a perfect square. We are doing all this so that this term becomes a perfect square. Okay, now we can see that this becomes a perfect square and you can write this as x plus 5 by 4 the whole square. And what is the RHS term? Now we have to solve both these fractions and make it as a single term before starting with the other section. So 3 by 2 plus 25 by 16. Okay, 3 by 2 plus 25 by 16. What happens here? Multiply here with 8. So we can write it together as 49 by 16. So x plus 5 by 4 the whole square is equal to 49 by 16. Now you have a perfect square on one side of the equation and a constant on the other side of the equation. So when you have so, what you can take? You can just take the roots and find the answer for the equation. So similarly, I'm going to do it over here. So x plus 5 by 4 is equal to plus or minus root of 49 by 16. What is root of 49 by 16? Root of 49 is 7 and root of 16 is 4. So you can write this as x plus 5 by 4 is equal to plus or minus 7 by 4. Right? Now what you can do? X is equal to minus 5 by 4 minus 7 by 4 is one of the roots and the other root is minus 5 by 4 plus 7 by 4. Right? So what happens here? Minus 12 by 4 and here minus 2 by 4 which is minus 3 is one of the roots and the other root is 1 by 2. We can see that when you have roots, you found the roots of this has minus 1 minus 3 and 1 by 2. So these are the roots of these quadratic equation and you found these roots using completing the square method. And now I'm going to do with another problem. So the last problem, so that you will get a better understanding on how to deal with completing the square method. Okay, 2x square plus, what is the step? 2x square plus 9x minus 8 is equal to 0. So this is our equation, right? And in this equation, what we are going to do? The same step when the terms are not on the same side of the equation, you have to make all these terms on one side of the equation. It's already satisfied. The next step is that the x square coefficient should be of unity. To make it unity, what you do? You divide all these by 2. So what happens? X square plus 9 by 2x minus 8 by 2 is 4. So I'm writing like this. And next step is that group together x square and these terms and write the constant on the other side of the equation. So that is also done. Then the next step is take the half the coefficient of x, the whole square, and add to both sides of the equation. So x square plus 9 by 2x plus 9 by 4 the whole square plus 4 plus 9 by 4 the whole square. Can we do an addition on these kind of equations? Yes. Unless and until you follow the equality of equation. What is the equality of equation? When you add a number to one side of the equation, you have to do the same on to the other side of the equation. So when we add 9 by 4 on one side of the equation, if you add a 9 by 4 on the other side of the equation, then the equality of equation is maintained and then you can do the changes. Okay, so now I'm going to make this a perfect square. So now this is a perfect square and we need to find out the answer for this. 81 by 16. So you have to multiply here 2x square plus 9x. It was plus 8. Okay, I did a wrong. So I'm going to make it minus 4. Here is minus 4. So minus 64 plus 81 by 16 is equal to x plus 9 by 4 the whole square. Right? So what happens over here? X plus 9 by 4 is equal to 17 by 16. So taking the roots on both sides, what happened? X plus 9 by 4 is equal to plus or minus root of 17 by 16, which you can write it as x plus 9 by 4 is equal to plus or minus root 17 by 4. Right? So what is the next step? So x is equal to minus 9 by 4 plus or minus root 17 by 4. The fraction terms or the denominator sections are same, so you can group together and write it as minus 9 plus root 17 by 4 is 1 root, and the other root would be minus 9 minus root 17 by 4. So these are these two roots of this quadratic equation. Okay, if you have any doubts, please let me know, and please feel free to reach me under my email ID, or also you can comment under my video. I'll be always there to help you out. Okay, once again, let's discuss what are completing square. On completing the square, the first step is to rearrange the equation, and the second step what we do, we make the coefficient of x square term unity, and on the third step, we rearrange the equation so that x square and x terms are on one side of the equation and the constant is on the other side of the equation. After that, the last and the final step, we had half the coefficient of x, the whole square, onto both sides of the equation, and then what becomes the LHS become a perfect square, and solve the fraction on the other side of the equation, fraction or number on the other side of the equation, and then find the root. Then that's it. So this is how you find roots of a quadratic equation using completing the square method. And on my next video, I'll be covering upon how to deal with quadratic formula, or how to find the roots of a quadratic equation using quadratic formula. For that, I'll be first deriving the formula of quadratic formula by using completing the square method. And also, I have a small reminder that if you wanted to watch any videos other than this, you can just check my playlist. I have a couple of videos more, so please feel free to reach me. Okay, so that's all for today, and have a nice day. Bye bye.